EA Sports. Tonight's matchup features two quarterbacks who will be trying to lead their team to victory. It's the Ravens going up against the Chargers. So with kickoff straight ahead, we'll check in with our broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
America's finest city on about as fine a Sunday afternoon as you're ever going to see. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Baltimore Ravens and the San Diego Chargers. Possible run anticipation. Here's the D-line sandwiches together. They'll run it now out of the gun. And nothing doing on his first run. Back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. And this O-line, it is the lifeblood of the offense.
They established the tone. Mean, nasty, physical. They can't wait to get after people. That allows the rest of the offense to feel confident.
That was second down run for Murray. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. He only got a couple on that one, so not a ton of help. They'll have a third and eight forthcoming.
Here we go. Flex round.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And he locates Luke Wilson. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41.
It fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic. So anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there able to concentrate, catch it, and even add a little extra at the end with a short run.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. It's caught on the left side by Kurz. 23 yards on the play.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels.
Ohio! Come on, Ohio! Ohio! Flex round!
Now the Georgia Southern man. This is Jarek McKinnon. Calling a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Second down to the offense in search of 6 yards.
Here we go! Grand 38!
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And to the left side here, Wilson. And it looks like he'll be just a yard shy of the 5 here as he's out at the 6.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
The slot man in motion right. So the chains are on their sides. It's first and goal from the 6. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. He'll get 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a second and goal. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
Clock winding down. Again, it's Murray. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Chargers. Latavius Murray, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Chargers have taken a first quarter lead. Steven Hauschka for the point after. And the Chargers grab the 7-0 lead. Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. That'll be taken in the end zone. They juked him. They'll bring it back to just about the 25. Call it the 24-yard line. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. First carry now. This is Johnson. And he's brought down. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
How many times do we say in this game is speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways. In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. And that led to a really nice game.
And he's brought down. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you can get much more balance than this. Big time run. Big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
Now Osweiler on second down. Oh, he's able to out-muscle him here as he pulls it in. And the play goes for 19 yards, gives him a new set of downs. And the offense lining up first and 10.
All right, here we go.
A first carry for the rookie, Procise. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. And if this offense is going to flow today, certainly the running back will be a key piece.
Without a doubt, because they asked their runner to not just do that, but to block, to catch, to help set a tone for their offense.
Green 39.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Here's Osweiler to throw. That is caught inside the 5. And he's brought down after a good gain. 23 yards on the play.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end. A guy that you can line up anywhere. In the slot, out wide, in tight. Doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. In a great spot. It's 1st and goal from the 3. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. It's a loss of a yard there, and now 2nd down. 2nd quarter now. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis with you. It's the Ravens who have the football, and they'll come up looking to keep this drive moving. Fullback try and take him home. And he will take it in for a Ravens touchdown. Patrick DeMarco, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Ravens are an extra point away from tying the football game. And he's got it up and through. So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Now the Chargers offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
Here's Murray now as they run it to start the drive. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. A gain of three, second down.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Now Prescott. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable. Usually an excellent target and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. Here's Prescott. A dump down to McKinnon. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. A good pick up there of 20 yards. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
They'll come out in the pistol. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going to loft this one deep left sideline. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
Flex round. Ohio.
Out of the gun now on third down. He's got the completion to Strong. Well, we saw the practice film this week. They wanted to focus on these intermediate passing plays, and it paid off there.
And they took that focus not just to the practice field, but in the film room to show the guys exactly what they wanted, what types of looks they should expect to get, and how they would beat those coverages each and every time, and it paid off on that play.
And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of four, and it'll be second down.
On offense, the guy that you want to have the best eyes on the field are your quarterback, so you can see everything pre-snap, and then, of course, as the play develops. On defense, oftentimes it's the linebacker. And on this play, his eyes took him right to the ball, and he made a nice tackle.
15 yards through the air and a first down.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay inbounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grab. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. They bring a man off the corner that time, and he gets home for a loss of six.
Come on, let's go! Grand 3, Ohio! 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 Ohio!
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. Jalen Strong, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big-time drop.
Come on, let's go! Grand Ohio! Ohio! Flex round! Flex round!
In motion left is Hopkins. Time running out here on the play clock. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. The loop, and he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Dominic Easley in there to get him for a loss of nine, and that'll lead to fourth down. The Chargers will bring out the field goal unit now. This will be from 49 yards out. And Hauschka's kick is good. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. And Charles, they get the field goal. Took him a dozen plays, though.
Work with me on this one. You know what I'm about to say, right? Bend but don't break. That's what came into play here for the defense. 12 plays were run at them. They only gave up 3 points. In a lot of ways, that's a win for the defense.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was, as he'll only get back to the 16-yard. Start the drive on the ground with Johnson. Trying to turn the corner, but they string him out and stop him at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down. Well, they know how to protect the pass, but sometimes cornerbacks, they can also stop the run, can't they?
Is that what we call a complete corner? Yeah, because we're so used to these guys just being defenders in the pass game. How about the guys who can come up and make the tackles? That's what we just saw there for no gain, too.
Second down, Osweiler. He's got the hook up to John Brown on the right side. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds. Because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? Well, they get the completed pass, but still have more to go here on third down. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
No. Shot, here we go.
Brown, the lone receiver left. Osweiler now to throw on third down. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. He was looking for Terrence Williams that time, and it brings up fourth down.
Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good. But when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion, as we just saw there, that's winning football.
And in their own territory, needing only a few inches, they're going to line up to go for this thing on fourth down.
Touching now, Barney.
sneak Osweiler. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back to San Diego after this timeout. Johnson, and he's brought down. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
Really good solid run right there, and they did it from a four wide receiver set. And if you're an offensive coordinator, they used to tell people, hey, we're going to throw the football. Now they use four receivers on the field to spread things out, give them more running lanes and more options. And also, it usually takes the bigger defenders off the field, makes the defense lighter and easier to run against.
First for Johnson, and hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
It's been a struggle this entire game trying to move the ball on the ground, but every now and then you find a little chink in the armor, and that type of run right there lets them know that they can't stop every single run for almost no gain.
Now Osweiler on second down. He finds his target, Terrence Williams. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Hurry up, here we go. Green up, first. Come on, guys. Go on, guys. Watch it now, Hardy, Hardy.
On second down, here's Osweiler. Fuller brings it in over the middle. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Will Fuller, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Ravens have retaken the lead.
And while that touchdown does not give them an insurmountable lead, it's still a lead, and that always feels good to a team.
They'd love to take that into the lockers, but a little time left on that clock, so some work to do.
I like that. I like how you're guarding against a letdown there.
Already looking forward.
Coaching them up from right up here in the booth.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. And now San Diego getting set to go. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
In motion is strong. Now a play fake here on first down. He's got time. Escaping the pressure right. Hopkins on the grab over the middle. And all the way down to the 26. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So the offense has it first and 10. Slot man moves right. Here's Prescott. Flushed out right. This will be caught inside the 10. And he's brought down. 18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So they're operating in the red zone. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left. The Pro Bowler DeAndre Hopkins, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down.
All defenders get tired of hearing about their lack of hands and why they're playing defense instead of offense, but in this situation, it was the hands that made the play. Batting the ball away on an attempted touchdown pass, excellent job, way to knock it down.
In motion is strong. They'll look to throw again. This will be caught at about the six. Call it a pickup of seven, and that is going to set up third and goal.
It's funny, throughout the time that we've been together, when we talk with running backs about the ability to catch the ball, their eyes light up when they talk about open field and having one-on-one matchups, don't they?
Yeah, they do. And that's the reason why. What we just saw, shedding those tackles, and that's what they're used to doing.
It is, and it starts at the beginning of the play, one-on-one matchup if someone's trying to cover them. But they also like those one-on-ones downfield after the catch when they're running with the ball. They think they're going to win those, too.
Third and goal now. The defense looking to hold. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. And likely time for one final play here in the half, so they will go for it on fourth down. They come out here in the eye. They'll try and run with Murray. And he fights his way in for a Charger touchdown. Latavius Murray in the final seconds of the first half. And the Chargers have once again taken the lead. So they're able to capture the lead here just before halftime.
And not only that, they get the ball to start the second half.
That's right.
This is almost like basketball down the stretch, right, where you get the two-for-one situation. We're trying to get two shots to your opponent's one. In this situation, they got the touchdown. They'll get another shot at to start the second half.
Could be a big turnaround. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And with a new rule, that decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he only gets to the 20. So we've hit halftime, just a field goal separating these two teams at the break. As we are off to Orlando now to check in with Larry Ridley. He's standing by with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry? This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Out come the Ravens now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here.
All right, here we go. Three, nine, ten.
Here's Osweiler. Screen play, Johnson. And he's able to get up here to the 26. Give him 2 yards on that play, and that's going to bring up a third down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Offense faces a third and medium with 6 yards left.
Detroit! Detroit! Back to the NFL! Here we go!
Out of the gun, a it's Osweiler. He finds his target, Fuller. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down.
That was a nice completion on an out route. And those types of plays are the result of arm strength by the quarterback and timing by the receiver.
Shift together here from the D-line. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. They'll throw on first down with Osweiler. It's caught on the right side, Williams. That one goes for 24 yards. He had time, was able to survey the field and find a soft spot in that zone coverage.
And that's where it gets difficult for a defender, Brandon. You go to your spots on the field that you have to cover, and when the offense finds an area that you're not in, that's where they throw the football.
A first down carry here for Johnson. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there. And it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Now Osweiler on second down. And this one is incomplete. Will Fuller was the intended target. And that'll make it third down. The line to gain is the 33 on third down. From the shotgun, Osweiler. A fight for the football, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Andre Howe. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. Now a look at the Chargers offense. They get ready for their first possession of the second half. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush, pass rush, pass rush. Whether it's the guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the football.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here. And he'll take this one up close to the 25-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
In my book, that's running the ball well, but with intelligence. How about him keeping the clock moving, staying in bounds?
Yeah, even though it's the third quarter, you're thinking ahead, aren't you? This is where your running game can really help you with a lead in the second half.
I agree totally. It's not just end of the half situations that you worry about the clock. It's throughout the game. And with a lead, stay in bounds. Make them fight harder to try and catch you.
He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. Give him 7 on the play, and that'll bring up a 3rd and 1.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Still in search of the first down after that last completion. And Charles, a couple extra defensive backs in here on 3rd and 1.
Not expecting them to run it at all.
They'll run here. It's Murray. And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. So in their own territory, but they only need a few inches, so they're going to opt to go for this thing. We'll see. Maybe a surprise pass. A run. What will they do? We're about to find out. 4th down. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the Ravens get the football back and in great shape. The Ravens offense now, they get set to head back on the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's get back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
And brought down there by a pair of Chargers on the stop. Well, a well-executed blitz, no doubt. Great job by the linebacker. Maybe the quarterback, if he could have seen that, could have audibled there.
Yeah, he needed to be in a different play because that one just meshed perfectly for the defense. All the gaps were filled except for the one the offense really wanted to run through, and that was filled by a big man wanting to make a tackle.
And he made a great tackle. On 2nd down, Osweiler. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
Defense has set themselves up nicely. Third and 10 now. Now a handoff, Johnson. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. And a loss of three to bring up four. Here's Justin Tucker now for the Raven field goal try. From the right hash, this from 53. And he's going to miss this one. That is no good. Well outside the left upright. And this score will stay right where it is. So an empty possession there. What do you think went wrong, Charles?
Well, it looked like maybe the plant leg might have given way just a little. And when that happens, guys have a tendency to pull through the ball to compensate. And in doing so, sent this one off target.
They begin the drive with a run by Murray. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down. Second down following the run.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
And he'll get it down to the 47 here. It's a pickup of six and good enough to move the chains.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
Fresh set of downs here. Watch right, watch right. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. And the back goes into motion. The play clock's running down. Now Prescott. And he fires one incomplete. Latavius Murray, the intended receiver, out of the backfield. And now it's second down.
So many offenses want to include their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out or check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
Here's Prescott. Strong grabs it over the middle. A really nice gain of 25 yards. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there. They'll need to get the playoff quickly. And we're back now in Mission Valley and San Diego. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
I know that every now and then we get in those meetings with coaches, and you almost want to roll your eyes when they talk about staying on schedule when they're moving the football. But would you say a 7-yard run is ahead of schedule?
Fourth quarter with a lead, you love that, don't you?
No doubt about it, because staying on schedule is trying to get four downs on first down. They did that plus three.
Again, it's Murray. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. A 5-yard gain, and now they're set up first and goal.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
And here we go on first and goal. They'll try to run it in with Murray. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
The tight end changing his position. Time running out here on the play clock. Toss play to McKinnon. Trying to turn the corner, but he's going to be stopped right near the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, and they're going to need to come up with something better here on third and goal. This will be play number 8 on the drive. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. This will be play number 8 on the drive. It's third and goal.
Here we go. 5-9.
They'll bring the tight end in motion right here. They'll look to throw on third and goal. They'll roll him out right. That's complete right around the 8. Call it a 1-yard gain on the play, and that's going to make it fourth down.
I wouldn't be surprised to see the next step in utilizing this position is to actually utilize more of a scat back in this spot, because we saw the catch there, right? He made it. He's a bigger, stronger guy, maybe not quite as elusive as maybe someone else you would think.
Yeah, didn't get the big yardage there. You might have a smaller back. So they get the 3 here, but you wonder whether that's going to be enough.
Yeah, I mean, you've now made it so they need a touchdown rather than a field goal to catch them. But you're right. If they'd gotten 6 out of that drive, this would be a much different game.
Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah, get a little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this up over the 25 to the 26. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
Here we go now. Green 39. Green 39.
They go to Johnson again. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They give him 17 yards that time, as that'll move the chains.
Whenever we meet with coaches and they always talk about wanting to establish running the football, it's oftentimes with a good tight end who can control the line of scrimmage and the point of attack, and they're becoming harder to find because the colleges are giving us a whole lot of receiving tight ends, former wide receivers who can run, not necessarily block very well. In this case, though, we saw 2 tight ends on the field, both of them with the ability to block, and he ran the ball successfully behind that power set.
Tackle made there by Zach Brown. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. 2nd down and 10. Now they'll throw it with Osweiler. Over the middle here to Brown. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and it'll be 3rd down.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Time starting to run out here in the fourth. This defense just trying to keep the offense off the board and preserve this potential victory. Now it's Osweiler. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. That one was intended for John Brown, and that brings up fourth down.
Well, that plays a statistic that's going to go on the defensive team stat sheet. Won't necessarily reflect in ours, right, the overall game sheet. But you and I know that they keep count on pressures, hits on quarterbacks, all those things, hoping to increase that throughout the game. And here we are in the fourth quarter, and they got a big one.
Yeah, it's such a close game, a very big one. One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Here we go. It's Osweiler on fourth down. He's going to go for a big play downfield. The Ravens go for it, but come up empty. And the Chargers will get the football back in excellent field position. And now San Diego getting set to go. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. Murray, the lone setback. He's going to get the football. And after the nice stiff arm, the next wave swarms in quickly for the stop. And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards. And it'll bring up a third and two more. On third down, Murray. Room here to run. A gain of 19 and picking up the first.
And that run was what a lot of people call an explosive run. Gave them good yardage, solid yardage. They feel good about the whole thing, and they did it behind a two tight end set. It's always interesting to watch what offenses want to do with the two tight ends. Sometimes they line them up together for a power set. Sometimes they put one on each side of the line of scrimmage to balance things out. No matter what, though, when you see two tight ends on the field, your first thought is to think of run.
And now the Raven defense going to call a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. See if they stay on the ground for second down.
Flex round! Flex round! Here we go! Red 38! Red 38! Ohio! Ohio! Flex round! Flex round!
Carries piling up. It's Murray again. And he's brought down. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal.
Well, that's what we call an even front or an odd front. And an odd front's real easy to figure out. If that guy is lined up over the nose of the center, typically that's an odd front defense. Odd number of people, meaning 3-4 versus the 4-3, which is an even front. You've got to control those guys in the middle. Whether it's the nose or the two defensive tackles in a four-man front, if those guys can't get moved, you cannot run the ball in the middle of the field. And in that play, they were able to actually take care of business.
A 20th carry coming up now for Murray. And he's in for a Charger touchdown. Latavius Murray with touchdown number 3 in the game and 6 on the year. And the Chargers find a way to stretch their lead. And the lead is now 13. Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. Here comes the Raven offense now, ready for another possession. They can't do much at this point, partner. This one is going to go down in the loss column.
You don't make up for what has happened during the game in this sequence here. Maybe you hand it off and let someone run the ball if you so choose. But otherwise, just kneel down, call it a day, and try and prepare going forward.
On first and 10, it's Osweiler. And the Chargers rush is going to get there. Down he goes. Star Lotulelei in there to drop him as the clock continues to roll. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. One last shot for Osweiler. Dancing to his left. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game. And Charles, you know what coaches always tell us. We want to win our home games. That much we know. We want to protect our home turf. They got that done in this one.
Exactly right. When you start a season, everyone's goal, win all of your home games, split your road games, and you're likely going to be in the playoffs. But when you win at home, boy, what a great feeling that is. You don't even mind if people are at your house when you get home after a win like that.
That'll do it for us for Charlie.